Hello everyone, the previous lecture we have discussed the concept of position of the points with respect to the line what we have taken, like whether the points lie on the same side or opposite side. Okay, if at all both L11 and L22 are having the same sign, then same side of the line, and if at all both L11 and L22 are having the opposite sign, then opposite sides of the line. One of the important concept that also in rare cases we see, but one should have the knowledge over that. And even I have sent you the solutions for the question paper what you have appeared recently, and only 16 questions I have sent, because later the questions whatever are there simply based on the fundamentals, so you can also crack them, not an issue. 1 to 16 questions are a little bit difficult, so that for those I have sent the solutions, please go through and try to solve the questions once again. Now I am going to introduce you the concept of pair of straight lines. What is that? So far we are talking about the line equation, straight line equation, ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Means, when we are talking about two lines, a pair of lines, I will be getting two lines of this format in the form of a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. Let's say there is a point x1, y1 which satisfies both the line 1 and line 2. Then definitely the combined equation what we are taking for L1 and L2, the combined equation what we are getting by taking the product of L1 and L2 means a1x plus b1y plus c1 into a2x plus b2y plus c2 will also get satisfied by the point x1, y1. The basic thing is x1, y1 is a point that will satisfy the line 1 and line 2. And these two lines ki product is a second degree equation. That particular equation also will be satisfied by the point x1, y1. Okay, satisfied in the sense on substituting the entire result will be equal to 0. I said here on multiplying both the first degree expression, see a1x plus b1y plus c1 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 are the first degree expressions. Therefore, on multiplying them, definitely we are going to get the second degree equation. Whether that is homogeneous or non-homogeneous, we'll see later. Okay. Let us multiply it and see what kind of equation we are going to get. A1x into A2x. A1, A2x. And then A1x into B2y. A1, B2, XY. Plus A1, C2 into X. Multiplied A1x and C2. Okay. Plus B1y into a2x means a2 b1 into xy, this term and this term. First multiplying a1x with all the three terms and then multiplying b1y with all the three terms. When multiplying a1x with all the three terms, what we have got? a1 into a2 into x into x, sorry, x square. a1x into b2y, a1 b2 xy. a1x into c2, a1 c2x, b1y into a2x, a2 b1 xy, b1y into b2y, b1 b2 y square. Okay, and then b1y into c2, b1 c2y plus c1 a2x plus c1 b2y plus c1 c2 is equal to 0. Here you have all the terms like x square, xy, xy, x, x, y and y, and constant that is c1, c2. We have only one constant, that is product of c1 and c2. Let us regroup the terms and see what type of equation we have obtained finally. a1, a2, x square. And a1b2xy plus a2b1xy. What is common factor? We have the common factor a1b2 plus a2b1 into xy. And then we'll go with y square terms. How many y square terms we have? Only one y square term. That is b1 into b2 y square. And then we have a1b2 xy. Okay, completed. Next we'll go with x terms. a1c2 and a2c1. a1c2 plus a2c1 into x plus y terms. What are y terms? Y terms b1c2 and b2c1. b1c2 plus b2c1 into y plus c1c2 is equal to 0. Now we have arrived at the final equation, that the product of the linear equations what we have taken got finally in terms of, let's say it is some constant a, okay, ax square means what is a here? A is equal to a1 a2. Next, this is some constant, okay, that I am taking in the standard form as 2h. 2hxy means here 2h is equal to a1 b2 plus a2 b1, okay. And this is some constant b, means plus by square plus, means here what is b? b1 b2 is equal to some b. And then a1 c2 plus a2 c1 is some 2g. This is some 2g, and this is some 2f, and this is some c, means 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. Means the final output we got in terms of ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. Here what are the first degree terms and what are the second degree terms? First degree terms are 2gx and 2fy, degree 1, 1. Second degree terms are ax square plus 2hxy plus by square, second degree, second degree, even this also second degree because power 1, 1, 1 plus 1, 2. When you have product of the terms, okay, when you want to take the degree of that particular term, you will be adding the powers of that, okay. And you also have here the constant term, that is c is equal to 0. Means here the product of the equations a1x plus b1y plus c1 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 got in terms of the second degree equation, that is ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0, where a is equal to a1 a2, 2h is equal to a1 b2 plus a2 b1, b is equal to b1 b2, and 2g is equal to a1 c2 plus a2 c1, 2f is equal to b1 c2 plus b2 c1, and c is equal to c1 c2. This equation is called second degree non-homogeneous equation. Why? Because homogeneous in the sense every term of that particular equation has the same degree. If at all the terms are not having the same degree, then we call non-homogeneous. Here it is second degree, second degree, second degree, first degree, first degree, degree 0. What is the degree of constant? 0. Here it is a combination of second, first and 0 degree terms. Means such a equation is said to be non-homogeneous equation. What do we call? Non-homogeneous equation. Hope you understand. Please write. After writing this equation, please mention. An equation in two variables. An equation in two variables. An equation in two variables. Write this point under note, okay. An equation in two variables, x and y. X and y. Is said to be a homogeneous equation. Is said to be a homogeneous equation of degree n, in x and y, if the sum of the indices of x and y, sum of the indices means the index what we have here, x power 1 plus y power 1 means 1 plus 1, 2. If the sum of the indices of x and y in every term, is same and is equal to n, write the general form. For suppose you have like this, a naught y power n plus a 1 y power n minus 1 into x plus a 2 y power n minus 2 into x power 2 plus and so on, because here I have started with y power n and keep on decreasing and introduced x. Finally, what I will be getting? I will be getting a n x power n, because y is getting decreased and tell me x is getting increased, so that I will be getting the last term as a n x to the power n. Now you see here the entire expression is of nth degree, because degree n, here also degree n minus 1 plus 1 n, here also the degree n minus 2 plus 2 n, finally also we have n. Means in such a case you call that equation as homogeneous equation or homogeneous expression. Okay, right on. Where a naught, a 1 and so on, a n are real, where a naught, a 1 and a n are real and so on, a n are real, comma, is a homogeneous equation of degree n, in x and y. Right on. Point number 2. If the sum of the indices of x and y, in all the terms, is not the same, then the equation is called, a non-homogeneous equation in x and y. And this is the general form of the homogeneous equation, and the previous one was the general form of the non-homogeneous equation. Okay. Right on. Next point. Ax square plus 2hxy plus by square equal to 0. Is a general form of second degree homogeneous equation. In x and y. Okay, here all the three degrees are same, please notice. And coming to next point, ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस टू एच एक्स वाई प्लस बी वाई स्क्वायर प्लस टू जी एक्स प्लस टू एफ वाई प्लस सी इक्वल टू जीरो इज अ जनरल फॉर्म ऑफ सेकेंड डिग्री नॉन होमोजेनियस इक्वेशन इज अ जनरल फॉर्म ऑफ सेकेंड डिग्री नॉन होमोजेनियस इक्वेशन Okay, hope you got all the points here. First, we were talking about the line equation ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Then we are talking about a pair of lines which are in the form of a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. If there is a point x1, y1 which satisfies both the lines, then that point also satisfies the combined equation of L1 and L2, that is product of L1 and L2. On multiplying both the equations L1 and L2, we have got the output in the form of ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0, where a, 2h, b, 2g, 2f and c are the constants, and we also took the comparison. So now this entire discussion on pair of straight lines will be on two lines. One is of second degree homogeneous equation and other one is of second degree non-homogeneous equation. Whatever the theorems and applications we discuss, only based on these two. There will be lot of theorems in this particular concept. Listen carefully, and even here the concepts what we learnt previously are highly applicable. So please be in touch and don't get disconnected with the fundamentals whatever you have been learning from the beginning. Okay, and please work out the solutions through the worksheet, through the solutions what I have sent. Check once or twice and revise the concepts once or twice, then try to solve the applications. Thank you.